where y'all from? Yeah, where y'all from? You're from India? You know, the other time when I was eating Gujarati thali. Yo, now I'm really excited, eh? Because, like, I'm hungry. I have not eaten since the morning. I'm going to go eat food in Bombay.
What's up guys, my name is Nikhil and you're watching Menu Please, the show where we go around the city and try the best Indian food.
In today's episode, we're trying one of India's greatest creations. I'm talking about the Thali. And today we're trying two variations, one Gujarati and one Bohri Muslim. I'm so excited. I'm sure the Guju one is going to be good and the Bohri one is not going to be boring. Don't fire me, Netflix. I'm sharing both of these amazing thalis with an amazing friend of mine, Kaneez Surka. She's one of India's most famous improv artists right now and soon, she's got a stand-up special coming out on Netflix.
All right, so we're in Bandra. It's time to find Kaneez. Kaneez! Oh my god, I didn't even notice you. Are you excited to eat two thalis?
I am so excited to eat
two
thalis.
Let's do it, let's do it.
Does it sound like a song? Two thalis, two thalis. Two
thalis.
What's up guys, we're back in the food mobile.
It's like the Batmobile.
It's like the Batmobile because we're eating on the food show. The food's wagon.
Okay, let's move on.
Okay. So can you tell us a bit about your background and you grew up in South Africa?
I grew up in South Africa. My parents moved to South Africa during apartheid. I went to an all-white high school. I was literally the only Indian in my school. And I remember once a couple of friends came up to me and they're like, we see you as one of us. And at the time, it was a compliment. I was like, yay, I'm one of you guys. Because you're trying to assimilate, you're trying to fit in. So like, and like, even in India, when I came to India, a lot of my friends would be like, you know, we feel like you're one of us. You're not like the other Muslims. What is that even?
That's different.
Like, even like boys would be like, you know, Kaneez, you're not one of the girls. You're like, you feel like you're one of us, like the boys. In the moments, I didn't realize this. Yeah. I always felt like, yay, I'm like connecting and bonding and assimilating. Mm. And like, my whole life, people have told me, like, being Muslim or being Indian or being female was lesser than.
So you've done a lot of improv and then you've switched to stand up. How different has that been for you?
That's what I'm excited about my Netflix special. I had written this really tight script and then, so on the night, because I was so comfortable with my script, I improvised so much of it. And I kept all those improv moments because I was like, that's what makes Kaneez. Improv is my love marriage. Stand-up has been my arranged marriage that I've started to fall in love with.
So the restaurant we're going to is Shree Thaker's Gujarati Thali restaurant. They're renowned.
I know, I feel really bad. I thought like I knew all the thali places and my ego's hurt now that I don't know about this place.
This place, apparently, they do not let you leave until you eat everything, you try everything.
That's the thing, that's the nice thing about Gujarati thalis is that they make you, I feel like I'm in someone's house.
All right, the first round has arrived. A little salad.
The whole salad.
I like how everything is bite-sized.
Right?
And there are so many different sauces to dip into.
You sounded so foreign right now. Sauces to dip into. Is it dal bati?
Oh, this is exciting.
It's hard on that game.
So, thoda aur dal. You can't have enough meat.
I think you can. I think that's enough.
So, Alright, round 4 is here.
The sabzis. I love cabbage, by the way. Apparently, cabbage makes you fart.
We'll find out in restaurant number 2.
Gross. Wait, don't eat the vegetables without the roti.
Oh, shit. I'm going to try some of these little garnishes. I don't know, so, that's how call for items.
Yes, so in Gujarati, ye chapati hai na? Okay, great. So here's
Wow.
So there's sign language that the waiters use to each other to call for like different things when customers want it. Ye roti hai?
Yes.
Chawal hai? Khichdi. Okay.
Dal bati.
Sabzi.
Sweet.
Papad kicha.
So ghee ke liye kya hai? Should we eat this or wait for like a full?
This is to be eaten without anything.
So this is one of the only places in Bombay that serves 5 different grains.
Yeah, there's a lot of different.
Completely gluten free.
Jowari, bajra, corn, ragi, biscuit baki.
Wow.
Biscuit baki. Wow, dog.
Yeah, did you hear that?
So, thoda aur ghee dal sakte. This is
you
like.
You put so much ghee on your food, Nikhil.
It's healthy, you said.
Have some sharam. Nikhil, by the way, you know that there's more coming, right? There's like rice
it
left.
It can't be.
And dessert.
It cannot be. Yes. Legend said it would go on, but I didn't expect this. So, what was your favorite thing so far?
You know what? The tikka dal. I thought it was one of the best dal I've ever had.
Mine was the.
Dal bati. Yeah. Okay, what's this?
It's good.
Oh! I was expecting like. A panna cotta.
Finally looks like one of the final courses.
This is the khichdi. This is the shiznit.
This is hearty.
So khichdi curry is my go-to Sikh food.
Like I'm buzzing. I feel like
it's
so...
really good. It's like you ate a hug.
Hello again. We wanted to ask a few questions.
How long has this place run?
Since 75 years.
Oof. How long have you been handling the place?
30 years.
And what's it been like transitioning from it's your father's business to now you've not only taken over the business, you've taken over these loyal customers that are coming again and again?
I was very much in it because when I was young, my dad used to get me on Saturday, Sundays. Just have fun, eat, sit on the counter.
Were there like uncles used to pinch your cheeks when you were a kid and now you're older and they're like still coming here?
You're the same one, right? The mischievous one.
So Nikhil wanted to know like which roti goes with which sabzi. Is that a thing?
Yeah, usually they have a few combinations. Like bajra, ki roti goes with undiu.
Oh, so you do eat undiu with something?
Should we eat this or wait for like a full?
Oh no, this is to be eaten without anything.
This is to be eaten without anything.
Guys, I felt like I said a lot of things in the video about Gujarati food and then Gossip just came and said the opposite.
Before we stuff ourselves, we have to realize we have another restaurant to go to.
This needs to be a two-day shoot, guys.
This needs to be an experience that you come, eat the thali, go home and sleep. Oh my God. All right, so we've reached, that's Crawford Market over there.
This is Abdul Rahman Street, then my dad grew up on the street. And my mom grew up on the next street called Sarang Street. Oh. I know 22 Sarang Street and we're at 151.
What?
We have a long way to walk.
Wait, what?
I think this is it. This is the one.
Can't imagine how old this is.
Hi, Mamu.
Nice to see you. Yeah, please come.
So this is my mom's house. This is where she lives. It's obviously turned to an office right now. We weren't meant to come. We're just driving past. We're going to Kalba Devi.
No, good, you come. This office now, we are running since last 40 years.
You plug in your office. You plug in your business, Mamu. Plug it in, man.
Mamu, she has a Netflix special coming out soon.
Oh, wow.
Yeah,
is it?
That's what they're doing. We're basically going to be talking about Netflix. Yeah.
Oh, that's good. Huh?
Please watch it on Netflix, guys.
Alright guys, so the second restaurant we're visiting is Bohri Kitchen by a guy called Munaf. He used to work at Google but decided I'd much rather sell my mom's mutton samosas. So he invites people home over the weekends, gives them a taste of Bohri cuisine and I'm super excited. We're going to eat out of a traditional thal and as you can see, Kaneez is excited as well. Yeah, we're almost there. The table in the Gujarati Thali place was the size of this thali.
Yeah.
And it's just for the two of us.
Whole life I've had trouble of like finding a comfortable position on the thal. And now I'm just like...
Yeah, I feel like this is the optimal position to sit. Alright guys, so we're here with Munaf who runs the Bohri Kitchen. Can you tell us a bit about how to eat at a thal?
First, you have to cover your head.
Yes.
I feel great.
Right. Assalamu alaikum.
So why do we eat out of a large plate? From a point of view of being more resourceful. You don't get off from a thal until everyone's done eating.
Okay.
You don't get the next course until the previous course is complete.
Mm-hmm.
You always finish everything that's in front of you. You know, it's looked down upon if you leave any food or you waste any food.
Inshallah.
We'll do our best.
If God wishes, then it'll happen.
How exactly do we start eating?
So the way it is served is it's served in the center. So think of it as a large pizza. And a pizza slices your territory.
So don't enter my territory.
It's highly territorial.
Growing up and we were like, kids are so gross. No one keeps to their designated area.
Huh.
And then there's just like fluids flowing from like one person's food to another.
It's all part of the experience, yes.
But
the way to start the meal is with the namak ghani. So do you want to do the honors?
Yes, please.
So, take a small pinch of salt. The logic behind this, it's a natural antibacterial, so it cleanses your palate. It gets you to salivate before the meal comes, so you're more sensitive to the flavors. And now we can, I think, begin with the...
Let's begin.
So we are starting with the kharas. So these are the smoked mutton keema patti samosas.
Mm-hmm.
And these are nariyal kebabs.
Look at that Bohri samosas.
Okay, so now they brought ice cream.
So the nice thing of Bohri food is that we start with dessert first.
Really? And then they would have this and have savory again.
Yes.
So that's mind-blowing to me.
Right, so we did the kharas, which were the savory items. We did the mithas, the sitafal ice cream. And then comes the main course, the jaman.
Yeah, this is how I would eat as a kid and then get slapped. Because who eats chocolate chip ice cream before chungwa fried rice?
Bohris!
This is the culture I needed to be in.
This is the culture you need to be a part of.
So guys, we're serving you the ran.
So if there are seven people sitting around this ran, how do they begin? Like does somebody carve it?
Oh my God, there's so many questions. Can we just start eating the naan, Nikhil?
No.
Okay, the most aggressive person starts and then the rest follow.
But question, why is there no carving knife? We want you to eat
with my
fingers. Disgusting behavior.
The logic is the meat should be so tender that when you use your hands, it just falls off the bone. Yeah, let's go for it.
Bro, I just picked up a bone.
Thank you.
There's no meat.
I'll just take the meat.
Oh my God.
Here's all the meat.
Oh, it's so good. What happens when you've eaten one ran already and then another one comes? What do?
You run away from it.
Hey!
Should we get the main course, the jamba?
Yeah, let's do it.
So should we get rid of the ran?
No, you're crazy.
Okay, cool. Oh, sorry. This is the Bohri-style dum biryani.
That is so colorful.
Yeah, look how beautiful this is.
So that's a saffron. That's saffron color they are.
That's an appropriate color. Bohri-style dum biryani. Saffron and Bohri food.
I'm going to ask you guys this.
Yes.
It's spelt Bohra. But everybody says Bohri, so what's that all about?
Take it away, Mana.
So the community is called Dawadi Bohra. Bohri is slang.
So Bohra is the right way to say it.
And think of Bohri biryani, like,
oh my God,
it's a right mix of masala and rice. It's not like too dry or too wet. It's perfect.
All right, guys, thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
Yes.
All right, please finish the food.
We'll try our best. So, Kaneez, how are we going to finish all of this?
I'm going to pick a ninny again.
It's a great experience. It's just nice to like talk to people and sit down. You're forced to talk to people when you're eating at a thal. Speaking of sitting down, let's talk about your stand-up.
Oh, hey. Yeah, man.
Tell me what your new Netflix special is about.
It was 15 minutes. And I was like, what do I want to put in this 15-minute special? And I was like, you'll get to know Kaneez a little bit better. From coming to South Africa, getting divorced, to like wanting to be a mother. And like, so you'll get a little bit of everything in this.
What is it called?
It's called, it's Kaneez, let her do. It's part of the joke. You're like, my whole life, everyone's like, what is she doing? And then it's like, just, you know what?
Yeah, Kaneez, let her do it.
Yeah, let her do it.
Well, I'm very excited to watch it. Thank you so much for joining me on these two Thali adventures.
Thank you. Thank you for, like, you guys took me out to my favorite foods. It was a really nice day.
If you guys found it to be a great day, make sure to leave a like, share this video with your friends, comment what you think we should have in the next episode.
Yeah.
And be sure to watch Kaneez's special as soon as it releases next year. Actually, this year. I forgot that.
I forgot we're really.
I forgot this is releasing in 2020.
Netflix special is coming out next year, so please watch it.
And you have to watch my episode too, because we are going to air on Netflix next year too.
Oh yay! Anything of yours coming out?
Yeah guys, watch both of their Netflix things coming out. And I'll see you here on YouTube, on the Netflix YouTube channel.